Welcome to Resonate Church Wednesday night. Glad that you're here listening, and maybe you're listening and it's not Wednesday night. No matter what night it is, I'm glad you're here. I'm Pastor Erik, and let's get started. This series is called From the Heart. So tonight, I'm just going to give it to you from my heart. And so I'm going to start with a question for all of us. And so my question is, what has God given you? Think about it. What has God given you? That's a real question. And it's a question that I believe we really need to take a look at, not just tonight during this message, but we need to look at that really every day of our lives. What has God given you? What has God given me? And the reason we need to look at it is this. Why do we have to look at it? Why do I have to care? What does it matter? What has God given me? God expects us, you and me, to do something with what he's given us. He expects that because the talent that God has given us are given to you and I for a reason. Yes, God loves us. Yes, we're his children. Yes, he wants to bless us. God does bless our lives just because he's a good dad and we're his kids. There's a lot of times where moms and dads, you bless your kids because they're your kids. They don't necessarily deserve it, but you love them and you bless them. And God does that for you and I too. But there are talents that God gives you and I, and he gives them to us for a reason. And let's read scripture out of the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 25. I'm going to start in verse 14. I'm sure you're familiar with this, but I'm going to read it all the way through, and then we're going to talk about it. So, for the kingdom of heaven is like a man traveling to a far country who called his own servants and delivered his goods to them. And to one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1, to each according to his own ability. And immediately he went on his journey. Verse 16. Then he who had received the 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5 talents. And likewise, the one who had received 2 gained 2 more also. Here's the kicker. But the one who had received 1 went out, dug a hole in the ground, and hid his Lord's money. After a long time, the Lord of those servants came and settled accounts with them. Verse 20. So he who had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, Lord, you delivered to me 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents besides them. And his Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. Isn't that what we all want to hear? Well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. And here's what I want us to pay attention to, this next line. Enter into the joy of the Lord. Please remember that. And verse 22 says, and he also who had received 2 talents said, Lord, you delivered to me 2 talents. Look, I have gained 2 more talents besides them. And his Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. And the statement again, enter into the joy of the Lord. That definitely is a place where you and I want to live, in the joy of the Lord. But let's go on and read verse 24. Then he said, then he who had received the 1 talent came and said, Lord, this probably was a pretty awkward conversation at this point. But he says, I knew you were a hard man, reaping where you haven't sown and gathering where you have not scattered. And I was afraid and went and hid your talent in the ground. Look there, you have what is yours. Whew. Not a great conversation so far for the 1 talent man. But the Lord answered and said to him, oh, this is going to hurt. You wicked and lazy servant, you knew that I reap where I have not sown, I gather where I have not scattered seed. So you ought to have at least deposited my money in the bank, and at my coming, I will have received back my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to him who has 10 talents. In verse 29, for to everyone who has more, more will be given, and he will have abundance. But from him who does not have, even what he has will be taken away. And cast the unprofitable servant into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. I think, oh my goodness. So I have another question, you know. I maybe have a few questions, but who are you and I? Are we a five-talent person or a two-talent person or a one-talent person? Have we taken what God has given us and used it to benefit him, to bless him, to increase, because we are talking about the kingdom of God. Have we used that to increase the kingdom of God? So what are we doing with the talent that God has given us? Maybe you're sitting there going, maybe I am a one-talent person. Maybe I haven't been doing with it what I should. Well, the good news is the Lord hasn't returned yet. If you actually have been burying that gift that God has given you, it's not too late to dig it up. I think about that story. I think the one-talent guy, man, was he looking at the five-talent guy and then the two-talent guy, then all of a sudden he only gets one talent? I mean, what was he feeling like at that time? You know, is there times where you and I feel like we're lesser than somebody else, or we're not as important? You know, when I did a little studying on the talent, because in this story, the talent is actually talking about money. And if you compare a day's wage and what that talent was, if you do the math right, it's still actually in today's market, one talent is like $1 million. So to think, okay, even the lesser of the three talented servants, his Lord gave him $1 million. And I'm thinking, that's still a lot of money. But isn't it true we compare ourselves to others maybe that have more, and it can stifle us from doing what God has called you and I to do? We look at somebody else who we think is more important than us, and then it stops us from doing the things that God has called us. And you know what? We can't let that happen. I'm going to read a verse out of Isaiah. It's chapter 41. Listen to this. It says, for I, the Lord your God, will hold your right hand, saying to you, fear not, I will help you. You know, one of the things that the one-talent servant said, he was afraid. And it's just crazy what fear does to us. Let me read a verse out of 2 Timothy. It's chapter 1, verse 7. It says, for God has not given us a spirit of fear. We don't have to be afraid. It doesn't come from God. He didn't give that to us, but he gave us power and love and a sound mind. And I'm just thinking about this story. Isn't it crazy what fear does to us? You know, the one talent servant was in fear. And fear, when we're acting out of fear, we lose all logic. I mean, we throw it out the window. It's like, wouldn't it seriously, if you had $1 million, wouldn't it have been easier for him to just go to the bank and put it in the bank? Yet, because of fear, he dug a hole. And I'm thinking, how big of a hole do you have to dig to hide $1 million? And then what do you, once it's in the hole, then you got to fill it up. And then you got to make it look like you didn't dig a hole because you don't want somebody digging it up and taking it out. So I'm thinking, that is a lot of effort, a lot of work, where he could have just gone to the bank and got interest. See, fear causes us to act not only ungodly, but illogical. It just doesn't make sense. Especially when you and I know that God has given to you and I his power, his love, and he put his mind in us. We can think right. We can think straight. We can do the right thing. The truth is, God's not going to give us more than what we can handle. God knows your talent, your ability, Scripture said, and he will give us according to our ability. Let me read out of 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 10. It says this, as each has received a gift, use it to serve one another as good stewards of God's varied grace. See, the gifts that God gives you and I, he wants us to use those gifts to serve one another because we're stewarding it for God. See, what does Scripture say? No matter what we do to the least of these, what are we? We're doing it for God. And God will recognize that. And we don't have to be afraid. See, one of the mistakes I think that the one talent servant did, he compared himself to the others. If they were in the same room, which I think they were, it seems like when you read the story, I'm just guessing that, but he called the three, and when the one got five talents and the other got two, and then he got one, put yourself in that story. How does that make you feel? It makes us feel bad only if we're comparing ourselves to somebody else, you know. We need to look at everything that we get from the Lord as a blessing and not compare ourselves to somebody else. Maybe there's a lot of times where you feel like that one talent servant. Well, let me remind you, if you do feel like that one talent servant, that was $1 million. If somebody came up to you today and gave you $1 million and said, it's yours, I'll come back, but it's yours to work, and that would be a thrill. I mean, it's not a dollar. So even to think, well, I might be the less of the servants, that was $1 million. And God trusts you way more than that. The gifts that God has poured into you are worth way more than money. And we need to use those gifts to serve and to honor God and to bless each other. Let me read this scripture out of Galatians. It's chapter 6. It's verses 4 and 5 out of the Message Bible. I just liked I liked how it read, and it, I got a little bit more out of it. So this is out of the Message Bible. It says, make a careful exploration of who you are and the work that you have been given, and then sink yourself into that. Don't be impressed with yourself. Don't compare yourself to others. Each of you must take responsibility for doing the creative best that you can with your own life. See, that's all God is asking for you and I. That you and I would say yes to him. That you and I would do our best. A lot of times, if we're going to compare ourselves to somebody else, it's going to be real hard for us to do our best. Don't compare yourself to anybody. You just say yes to God. Do your best and honor him. So let me just close up with this. God has given you everything that you need. Scripture said he's given you all things that pertain to life and to godliness. He's given you everything you need. Be satisfied with what God has given you. Be satisfied with who you are in God, because you are great in God. Number two, don't compare yourself to others. That's a waste of time. You're unique. You're special. You're incredible. And God made you that way. God made you with a plan and a purpose for you to accomplish, to bless him. And then number three, don't be afraid of anything. Know this, God's got you. You're in his hands. He's got that perfect plan. Don't be afraid. God bless you. Have a great night. See you next time.